Good afternoon to both of you. Yes, this animal first spotted a couple of days ago. Where it is now, anyone's guess. But we spoke to the woman earlier whose dog was killed when it came face to face with that mountain lion.
He's trying to get his mouth open to get him out. She had him by the head.
Using her hands, Eileen desperately tried to pry open the jaws of a mountain lion as it attacked her 10-year-old miniature schnauzer, Pumbaa.
Their jaws just locked down. There's nothing. I had a broom. I couldn't get him out.
It was early Thursday morning on Evening Sky Drive, the Simi Valley neighborhood nestled against the Santa Susana Mountains.
It didn't come after me until it was too late, and then that's when I went in the house, because then I knew it was probably not going to be good, that he was protecting his dinner.
Eileen says Pumbaa was like a son, and despite the terror of watching him die, she spent the afternoon warning her neighbors when she heard there had been another sighting Friday morning.
I don't want the animal killed because he's just trying to survive, and they were here first.
Late Wednesday night, hours before Pumbaa was killed, this resident's dog, Sammy, was also attacked but survived.
So I certainly hope that the animal control could somehow set a trap to capture the mountain lion, because is putting everybody in danger here.
Wildlife officials say the tracking collar on the big cat's not working, but they believe she might be P35, a 9-year-old female mountain lion that was last tracked in these very mountains 2 years ago.
The lion just looks like he's beat. He's tired and hungry.
My question is, why don't we try to catch this cat? It looks hungry and it looks like it needs help.
Fish and game officials say unless a protected species threatens a human, it's not considered a public safety threat, but they have tranquilizers on standby. In the meantime, Eileen's urging her neighbors to keep their dogs inside.
You know, I was the most protective parent there was, and it still happened to me.
Fish and game officials said they will not relocate this animal unless it poses a public safety threat. And they also said they're instructing Simi Valley police that if they see it again, to use non-lethal rounds. I'm Christina Pascucci reporting live from Simi Valley for KTLA 5 News. Mark and Lou.